you now to look into each other's eyes and repeat your vow.
I'm never going to make it through what you wrote. In my heart, I take you on a wild ride. Like I said yesterday, as long as it's not a small world, I'm more of a 7th-worst mind frame. But it's going to be a journey together. But I give thee that which is mine to give. You cannot command me, for I am a free person, but I shall serve you in every way that I can. And the honeycomb will taste sweeter, coming from my hand. I pledge that your arms shall be the ones that I lie in at night, and your eyes the ones in which I smile in the morning. I pledge to you the first bite of my meat and the first drink of my cup. I pledge to you my living and my dying, each equally in your eyes and your care. I pledge to you to be true, but gentle with my words. I shall be a shield for your back and you for mine. I shall not slander you, nor you me. I swear by the rising of the moon and the setting of the stars to love you.
Traditionally, the marking of the passage to the status of marriage is symbolized by the exchange of rings. These rings are a symbol of the unbroken circle of love. Love freely given has no beginning and no end. Love freely given has no giver and no receiver, for each is the giver and each is the receiver. May these rings remind you always of the vows you have taken here today. Have you today brought rings?
Oh, no. Harmony, now!
Renee, I give you this ring.
Renee, I give you this ring.
That you may wear it as a symbol of our union.
That you may wear it as a symbol of our union.
Wendy, I give you this ring.
Wendy, I give you this ring.
That you may wear it as a symbol of our union.
That you may wear it as a symbol of our union.
The final reading that Wendy and Renee chose for this was from Pocahontas. Quite appropriate, considering the unlikely meeting to begin. If I never knew you, if I never felt this love, I would have no inkling of how precious life can be. And if I never held you, I would never have a clue how at last I find in you the missing part of me. Wendy, Renee.
We are very near the end of this ceremony. We've exchanged vows, rings, and have been bound by the blessings of many parts in the ancient ritual of handfasting. I'd like to leave you with a few thoughts as you go forward on this special day. Above you are the stars, below you are the stones. As time passeth, remember, like the stones should your love be firm, like the stars should your love be constant. Let the powers of the mind and of the intellect guide you in your marriage. strength of your wills bind you together, that the power of love and desire make you happy, and the strength of your dedication make you acceptable. Be close, but not too close. Possess one another, yet be understanding. Have patience with one another, for storms will come, but just as quickly will pass. Be free with affection and warmth, and share love often. Have no fear. Let not the ways or words of any other give you unease, for your bond is sacred above all others. Now, with the power vested in me by the Supreme Court of the United States of America and the state of Tennessee, I pronounce Wendy, and Mary. Together they live happily ever after. Please face your friends.